hey, let's say I'm new to PUBG and I want to know that how many ways can I customize my characters. Before we go into this, let's learn some of the basic counting rules. So now you are so hardworking, you click on this video, we deserve to get two gifts from your parents, a phone and a device. Let's go to pick your phone now. So we're going to give you two choices, an iPhone or a Samsung phones. So choosing a phone is considered as one of the event. So we have two ways to choose a phone. So let's say you prefer an iPhone. After picking your phone, now let's go for the second gift, choosing a device, either a laptop, a PC or a tablet. So we have three ways to choose your device and you pick a laptops. So now you eventually choose an iPhone and a laptops. So let me tell you that this is only one of the possible pairing, because of course different people have different preferences. But how to find the total number of possible pairing? Eventually we can use the multiplication rules. They tell us that if there are a number of ways to doing something, and after the first event, we have b number of ways to finish up the second event, then they must have a times b ways to do both of the event in a sequence. Like just now, the first event is choosing the font. I give you two ways to choose the font. After that, the second event is choose the device, and we are provided with three ways to choose the device. In order to choose the font and a device, eventually we can use the multiplication rules, 2 times 3, which is 6 ways to choose the phone and the device. In order to use the multiplication rules, we must make sure that the event is in a sequence. And there's a keyword of AND, AND. Like just now, choose a phone and a device. And we need to make sure that both of the events are eventually independent to each other. What I mean is, the choices in B wouldn't be affected by the choices in A. It means that they didn't tell us that if I choose iPhone, then I cannot choose the MacBook. If there are no such rule is applied, it means that they are independent. Meaning that the choices in B wouldn't be affected by the choices in A. So now let me convince you with a graphical tree diagrams. So the first thing we're going to do is choose a phone. We have two choices. After we're done with choosing the phone, then we're going to choose a device. So let's say I choose a phone, then I choose a device. We have that particular of possible pairing, right? So can you see that how many pairing do we have after we choose a phone and a device? As we can see here, it's so clear that there are 6 ways, which is eventually proof that multiplication rule is working fine. So let's go back to find out that how many ways can I customize my characters. Can you see that? They provide us with a different event, choose our face, choose our hair, hair color, facial hair and facial hair color. So let us sort it out one by one. So the first event is going to pick my face styles. But how many options do they give it to me? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So the total way for the first event is 7 ways. So now we go for the second event. How many ways to choose a hairstyle? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So 9 ways to do the second event. And the third event is going to be pick my hair color. How many colors they provide to me? 6 colors. So 6 ways. The next, event number 4, pick the facial hairstyles. So unfortunately, only 1 choices. So 1 way to finish up the event. And lastly, we're going to choose the facial hair color. And we have, again, 6 colors to choose. So 6 ways to finish up the 5th event. In order to find out how many possible pairing is here, we're going to use the multiplication rules. Just times the individual number of ways to finish up the event. And in total, we have 2,268 possible pairing for the customizations. And now it's your turn. Leave a comment and tell me that how many ways can I customize a girl characters? Oops, your parents found out that you are playing games. So now you only deserve to get either a phone or a device. It means that if you choose a phone, you can't choose a device anymore. Or if you choose a device, you can't choose a phone anymore. So it means that we're going to combine both of the choices in both events for you to choose. Now we only left with 5 possible ways to happen in this kind of situations. This thing can be explained by using addition rules. It means that if we have A number of choices in the first event, and we have B number of choices in the second event, if only one of the event can happen, and you can only choose one, then we have A plus B ways for this kind of selection to be happened. Like just now, we have two phones for you to choose and three devices for you to choose, but now you can only choose one of the phone or a device. This is why we have only five possible outcomes, and this is what we call as addition rules. So it means that only one of the event can happen, no longer a sequence of event, no longer both of the event going to happen. It means that if A is happened, B wouldn't be happened anymore. If B is happened, A is no longer possible to happen. And one more thing is, both of the event must be mutually exclusive. It means that if the choices appear in A, it wouldn't be appear in B. If the choices appear in B, it wouldn't be appear in A. It means that if iPhone is in the A selections, then we cannot have iPhone in the B selections, or else we are double counting. So this is what we mean by mutually exclusive. And usually for addition rules, we have the keyword of or. Like just now, you only can choose a phone or a device. Let's look at some of the examples. How many ways are there to answer 5 true or false questions? So now we're going to prepare the slot first. We have question number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And we're going to figure out that how many ways that we can answer each of the questions. Since this is only true or false questions, we can answer either true or false. So it means that we have only 2 ways to answer for each of the questions. Since all of the events is going to happen, so we know it's going to be multiplication rules. So we can find the total way by times all of the number of ways for each of the questions. So we have the total of 32 ways to answer 5 true or false questions. How about now they give us that we have 5 multiple choice questions, and each of the questions we have 4 choices. So same thing, we have 5 questions altogether, but now each of the questions we have 4 choices. Means that we have 4 ways to answer each of the question. A, B, C, or D. So we have 4 choices for each of the questions. Since all of the events must happen and must be in a sequence, then now we can say that the total way of answering it, just by using multiplication rule, we can times all the number of ways, and we found out that it's going to be 1024 ways to answer these 5 questions. Next, how about now? They say that we have 2 ways to connect town A to town B. So these kind of things, we're going to draw it to visualize first. Town A to town B, we have 2 ways to connect it. First way and second way. And now, they say we have 3 ways to connect town B to town C. So now we have another town, town C. We're going to connect by using 3 connections. First, second, and third. The question is, how many ways can you travel from town A to town C through town B? Means that we're going to travel from town A, go to town C, but must be passing through town B, and then back to town A again by using the same route. So what do they mean is, we're going to travel from town A to B to C, and then back again to A, must be going through B. We need to decide for how many times. From A to B, 1 times. From B to C, 2nd. C to B, 3rd time. B to A, 4th times. So it means that all together we need to do 4 decisions. So from A to B, we got how many ways to do these kind of things? From A to B, we have 2 ways. So we have 2 ways. From B to C, eventually we have 3 ways. How about now from C to B? Since they say that when you go home, you must using the same route. If you are using the same route, means that you have no choice. You must use back the same route. So you have only 1 way left. And then now, from B to A, same thing. When you are going back, you must using the same route. So means that if you are using this one to go A to B just now, means when you go home, you also must going through this way. So you have no choice left for you, only 1 way. So all together must be 2 times 1 times 1 times 1, which is 6 ways. Next, how about now we change to by using different rod? Means that when you go home, you cannot choose back the same rod that you have been using before. So starting from beginning again, A to B, how many way? 2 ways. From B to C, 3 ways. But now the difference is you cannot use back whatever that you have been used before. So let's say I use this one already, and just now we also use this one. So we're going to remove both of the selections because we can no longer choose back whatever that we used before. So we have one choice reduced. So now C to B left you only 2 choices. B to A left you only 1 choice. So all together we have 2 times 3 times 2 times 1. We have 12 ways. Next, we have 26 different capital letters of alphabets from A to Z. And we have 10 different numbers from 0 to 9. They ask us to find how many ways you can choose an alphabet and follow by a number. So it means that we're going to choose the alphabet first, after that followed by a number. So how many ways we can choose an alphabet? Since they have 26 different alphabets, we have 26 ways. How about numbers? Of course, we have only 10 different numbers to choose. So since we have a keyword and, so it's a sequence, so this must be using multiplication rules. So we can say that it's going to be 26 times 10, which is 260 ways to choose alphabet and followed by a number. How about now they ask how many ways you can choose an alphabet or a number. So it means that we are going to choose alphabet or a number. So we have 26 alphabet and 10 numbers. Since we only can choose either one of it, so we're going to use addition rules, which is 26 plus 10, which is 36 way to choose one of the alphabet or one of the number. Hey, if you have any questions or would like to see any kind of video, leave your comments below and let me know. If you want to support us so that we could make more videos like this, the simplest way is just by sharing the video with your friends. Click the like buttons and consider subscribing to this channel. See you in the next video.